All right, y'all, I see you. I see you. country.
Theta Phi Sigma, Christian Sorority, Incorporated, was founded on September 23rd, 2009, in Montgomery, Alabama, by our lovely white diamond, Big Sister Lean On Me.
Who and what is a white diamond?
Girl, what?
Walking in. Hey.
looks like.
Okay, but wait.
and to Gloria Queen. To speak in faith what we desire, we speak to the unseen.
Father, the power in our voice and true vision in our eyes.
We cannot be speaking so high upon the open sky.
No, that's good people.
I just wanted to say a few words to everyone. Again, I want to say thank you for coming tonight. Thank you for your patience. Your time is very important to us. But I want to first say thank you to our family. Thank you for your love, your support, your understanding, your sacrifice, and most of all, your prayers. We definitely thank you for your understanding, because there's been many nights on Mondays when we had supposed to be 2-hour meetings that turn into 4-hour meetings because God just moved. So we won't have no more of those 4-hour meetings on Monday now. But I want to say to the 7 daughters of Zion here, not only am I your VOP, but I'm your sister in Christ. And these 3 months have been 3 incredible months. We have laughed together, we cried together, we shared stories, we prayed together. I have watched you grow so much spiritually, naturally, and most importantly, I watched you all grow into a sisterhood. You're looking at 7 individual ladies here with 7 individual personalities who all wasn't sure if they wanted to do a sisterhood, but they heard that call. So many are actually called and interested, but only a few are chosen. And this was the 7 chosen. They worked hard. They really poured a lot into it. They really built their sisterly bond. And when you hear 3 months don't sound like a long period of time. But 3 months when you're building spiritually and in the natural is incredible. It's something that you can't explain to anybody else who hasn't gone through this type of process. This really becomes your sisters. You love them, you cover them, you pray for them, you're bad and good. So I just want to say I'm so proud of you. I love you. You all are phenomenal. I can't wait to see what God's going to do with our ministry next. This is only the beginning. Alright, you ready to reveal?
Bones, and I'm weary of holding it in, and I cannot. God has placed in me a fire. There's a fire that sets the captives free. And that's why my sisters call me God's flamethrower. Oh,
you all know by now, I'm the loudest one of all my guys.
Go, girl.
Let me show you how loud I am.
Go get it. 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 Go get your blessing.
Go get it.
Go get it. Go get it. Go get it. Go get it.
Saint is just a sinner who fell down and got up.
So when I hear that song, when I hear those words, it reminds me that being saved doesn't mean that you're perfect. It just means that you're forgiven and that you've been restored. So when God asks us to get back up or helps us get back up, we need to ask ourselves how we're going to serve Him going forward. Well, I decided that I'm no longer going to lean upon my own understanding. And I'm going to be open to the will of God. So when God tells me to go right, I'm going right.
Come on,
when God tells me to go left, I'm going left. But Isaiah 1 and 19 says, if you be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. So I don't know about y'all, but I want all the grace and mercy that my Father has given me. That's why my line of sisters called me willing vessel.
Let's go, number six. What you got?
From this day forward until eternity. Like I told you, baby, before, you can call on me at any time. I'm there. I'm just so looking forward to the next few years we have together to just move for God and just change some things. So I just thank you, ladies. You've been wonderful since day one. I didn't know what God had in store, but He had something awesome. So I thank you for making this such a pleasant and wonderful journey, learning experience for me. You made it great. I love all of you ladies. And,
they didn't see me much, but they saw me on video. And that was after I had gone before the Lord and Sarah called me. And she said, Summer Edify. She called me a whole bunch of other things I can't tell you. She said, Summer Edify, do you want you to allow the Lord to use you to give line names like you did for the Foundation of Five, which is the first line for Proverbs Alpha. Happy anniversary. The very first line for Proverbs Alpha. And so,
that was my best friend in Jeremiah.
And you don't know the soul that but God gives you love for those people. You can't do nothing but give God the praise right back. Because when I sat down, my husband recorded the video. And he gave me the whole line name. I wanted to go back and change it. Because I just couldn't really find the scripture that I wanted. Sarah said, no, no, that thing can't. When you first said it. But I had never seen any of them to give them their individual names. I had not been to a meeting because I couldn't make it. But when they stood here tonight and they began to say what their line sisters called them, it really registered with me because God knew exactly what name to call them by. I didn't. But God said for every name that you were anointed to carry. Everything you went through, it was not for naught. But it's for every woman that you're now running to from this day forward. Hallelujah. Every word that comes out of your mouth is going to burn up the hurt.
Hallelujah.
Every person you serve, their life is going to be changed. For every noise you make, whether it's a war cry or a worship cry, it's going to break through the barriers of whatever atmosphere you're in at that time.
All right. Hallelujah.
And because people need to know who Jesus is, they need to know that they can approach you.
Come on now.
You can't be mean and nasty and say you love.